Dippy dooby dooby doo doo doo. Oh, what's going on here? Yes, it's late and very, very live. Hi, everybody. This is Mr. Duncan in England. How are you today? Are you okay? I hope so. Are you happy? Happiness. It is a very good thing to be happy in this world, because then life goes by in a much more pleasant way. I hope you are okay. Here we go. It's late and live, just to prove that we are both of those things. It is now 5 minutes past 10 p.m. All of my neighbors are now fast asleep in their beds, and it is just me awake, teaching English, talking about English to the whole world, or to whoever is interested. So it's nice to see you here tonight. Lots of things to get through. Of course, we have Mr. Steve coming later on. He is not here at the moment. He is at yet another rehearsal. Can you believe it? Yet another rehearsal. Mr. Steve might be the busiest man on the planet. I think so. I think Mr. Steve might be the busiest person in the world. So for those who are wondering when you can catch me, you can find me on YouTube on Sunday, 2 p.m. UK time, and on Wednesday at 10 p.m. as you can see right now. And both of those times relate to the UK. They are both UK time. So there we go. For those who are wondering, because lots of people ask me all the time, I get lots of people asking, Mr. Duncan, when are you on? So there, those are the times when I'm on. And don't forget, both of those times relate to the UK. I hope that is now very, very clear. Last Sunday, I was asked if I could explain a word on the live chat. Now, sadly, I didn't have time to answer the question, but there is the word right now. Can you see it? The word is altruism. Altruism. And this particular word means selfless concern. So if you concern, or if you concern yourself with the well-being of others above your own concerns or your own well-being, then we can say that you have altruism. Altruism. It's a great word. So maybe a selfless act. If you do something for others without any concern for your own well-being, or if you are expecting no reward, we can say that that is altruism. Altruism. It's a great word, a lovely, lovely word. So I hope that helps you. I hope you are here today, the person who asked me that question last week. Another question I was posed with, a word. Here's another word, a great word, benign. There it is. You may have heard of this word before. Benign is a great word. It means gentle or kind. So if you are gentle and kind, we can say that you are very benign. Benign. Also, if something is seen as not being harmful, it can also be described as benign. We often use this word when we are talking about diagnosis of cancer. So if you have a test on one of your cells in your body or a part of your body, and they find out that you don't have cancer, so the cell or the piece of your body that they examined has no cancer, we can say that it is benign. Benign. So that's a great word. Something is benign. It is gentle, kind, or it is seen as not being harmful. There it is. Ooh. So I hope you like those words. Thank you for asking. So here we go. It's Mr. Duncan. That's me. For those who don't know who I am, I teach English right here on YouTube. And here I am right now doing the same thing for you. Now, let me just set the live chat up on the screen. Just give me one moment because I haven't done that yet. So I'm just going to set the live chat up on the screen so everyone can see it, including me. Ah, yes, there we go. It's now ready to go. And here it comes now on your screens. So the live chat is up and running. Ahmed asks, do you have a channel in Telegram? In the Telegram application? No, I don't. I don't use that. I don't use many applications for communicating across the internet, to be honest. I use good old-fashioned email and also YouTube. I'm also on Twitter, and of course I have many followers on Facebook. So actually Facebook is the place where you can find me the most, besides YouTube. Of course, you can also find me on YouTube quite a lot. Helena is here. Hello, Helena, watching in Brazil. Hi, Mr. Duncan. Have a lovely live broadcast. Thanks a lot. I don't know what's going on with my throat today. It feels very dry. The air today is very dry. I don't know why, but it is very dry. Oh, that's better. I'm just having some much needed water. Nicole is here. I'm tired, Mr. Duncan, because here it is gone 11 o'clock. Are you tired, Mr. Duncan? I am not tired because I had a little rest earlier on. Alisa or Ailsa is here. It is after 2 o'clock in the morning where Ailsa is. Oh my goodness, you must be very tired at the moment. Very tired indeed. We will have a look at some more live chat a little bit later on. But would you like to see what the view was like tonight? We had a lovely, lovely evening. The sunset was glorious and everything was quite scenic tonight. So here it is, the view from my window tonight. Normally I do this on a Sunday as well, so I thought I would do it tonight because the view was so lovely. Oh yes, there it is. That is the actual view that we had this evening. So just about 3 or 4 hours ago, that was the view in my garden. And at the moment, the nights are starting to get shorter, which means that we have more daylight every day. And there it is. So these are actual views from my window tonight as the sun was beginning to set. And the weather today was quite nice, although we had some snow earlier. Can you believe it? We actually had some snow. There is another view, and you can see that the sun is starting to go down. It is starting to set. You can see the sky is now glowing with a beautiful warm red color. And there it is. There is the sun going down. That is tonight's actual sunset. And it was a beautiful evening, so I thought, I think I will record it and show it later on my live stream. So there it was, tonight's view from my window, and I must admit, the sunset was very, very lovely. And of course, we are well into spring now. We are right into spring, and also British summertime has also started. I know it's very confusing, but last weekend we changed the clocks here in the UK. We put the clocks forward by 1 hour. So Now the time difference is altered depending on where you are in the world. So if you are watching in another part of the world, you might find that the arrival time for me on YouTube will be slightly different by 1 hour. So I hope it hasn't caused too much confusion. Also this weekend, a new month arrives. Yes, we are into April on Sunday. Sunday the 1st of April, and it is also Easter Sunday. Will you be doing anything special for Easter? I know I will, because I'm going to have lots of chocolate. I will be doing that on Sunday because it is Easter Sunday. A lot of people around the world will be celebrating Easter. I'm just wondering now whether you will be doing the same thing. What do you do for Easter? Do you do something special? I have a feeling that Mr. Steve might have bought me a big Easter egg. But can I let you in on a secret? I have bought Mr. Steve an Easter egg. And do you want to know where I've hidden it? It's just behind this curtain. So just behind this curtain, there is an actual Easter egg. And it's the Easter egg that I'm going to give to Steve on Sunday. But please, don't tell him. It's our secret, okay? Please don't tell Mr. Steve that there is an Easter egg behind the curtain. Can you keep a secret? Can you? I really, really hope so. Because I trust you so much, you see. That's the reason why. Would you like to see an excerpt from one of my lessons? Now, for those who aren't familiar, there are lots and lots of lessons on my YouTube channel. Besides my live stream, there are also lots of recorded lessons. And now we are going to take a look at one of my recorded lessons. This is part of a lesson, and the link to the lesson is underneath this video. So if you want to see the full video, you can click the link later on underneath this video. So this particular lesson is all about the way you look, or to be more precise, your image. In our day-to-day lives, image plays an important role. When we are out shopping for fresh food, we are constantly judging the image of what we are looking at. A red apple might look better than a green one. A tomato with its stalk and leaves attached may look fresher. The image of even the most simple thing can alter the way we see it. Of course, what is pleasing to one person may not be so to another. This is why offering more choice to shoppers is a common one. You can buy some fresh tomatoes, or pick up some that have been put in a can. More choice means more customers. We often see image as being a real thing. The thing we look at has an image. It leaves an impression on us. But image can also exist in the mind.
We can imagine anything. Your imagination allows you to run free.
Albeit in a dreamlike way. Creativity tends to come from this imaginary process, so the power of imagery is a forceful one, be it right in front of your eyes or up here in your mind. There are many moments in your life where the way you look and how you show yourself to others is important. For example,
when you are attending job interviews while looking for work. You need to make sure that the image you are projecting is a positive one. There is a strong belief that first impressions are the most important ones. So it is crucial to make sure that the first impression you make on the person who could end up being your employer is a good one. A smart and tidy appearance can go a long way. There is a saying in English, beauty is only skin deep. This means that the outward appearance of a person does not give a complete picture of what they are like. It is what lies deep down in a person's character that is important. Also, it is worth remembering that beauty is in the eye of the beholder. What might seem attractive to one person may be completely repugnant or repulsive to someone else. Take a look at these images. Do they affect you in any way? Photographs and video playback allow us to relive moments from our lives and, in some cases, see things that will never happen again. To see those precious moments again can have a deep impact on you. When you take a photo or a video clip, you are capturing a moment of time, so it can be cherished forever.
Yes, it's a Wednesday night here in the UK, and it's coming up to 25 minutes past 10 o'clock. If you don't believe me, have a look at the clock, because that's what it says. Hello, good evening, and I really do hope that you are super duper today. We've had a lovely day here, even though the weather has been all over the place. This weekend, it is Easter Sunday on the 1st of April. So it is April Fool's Day and also Easter Sunday at the same time. I can't remember the last time we had April Fool's Day and Easter Sunday on the same day. I can't remember when that last happened. I think it's quite a long time ago. So what will you be doing for Easter Sunday? Anything special at all planned? I will be eating some chocolate. I have a couple of favourite brands of chocolate. One of them is called Lindor. Lindor. It's a beautiful chocolate. I think it's Swiss Swiss chocolate. And there is another brand of chocolate that I absolutely love, but it's very, very expensive, and it's called Godiva. So there is Godiva chocolate and Lindor chocolate. Both of these are very nice chocolate. Yes, they're sweet, but also they have a lot of cocoa in them as well. So they're not too sweet, but they do have very good ingredients in them. And I love them very, very much. So what are you doing for Easter Sunday? Will you be doing anything special? Here in Egypt, we have coloured eggs. Let's have a look, shall we, on the live chat. Here in Egypt, we have coloured eggs and we prepare salty fish for celebrating Easter, says Heba. Thank you, Heba, for that. Actually, I'm in the UK now, and in Korea, it is nearly 25 past six in the morning. But Ginny is in the UK. Oh, whereabouts, Ginny? Where are you in the UK? Alice says, I adore Lindor chocolate very much. Me too. Yes, I absolutely love Lindor chocolate. And the other one is Godiva chocolate, but it's very, very expensive. It is so expensive. Ernesto, please, Mr. Duncan, could you say a warm good night to my son, Francesco, who is now in Dublin City? Thank you, and a big hello from Italy. Okay, Ernesto, and a big hello to your son, Francesco. Hello to you, watching, hopefully, in Dublin. Aurora is here. I love that type of chocolate. Anna is a very big fan of dark chocolate. Yes, to be honest with you, I have to be in the mood for dark chocolate. I don't always like dark chocolate. TGN says, I love Maltesers. Yes, so do I. I absolutely love Maltesers very much. Natalia says, do you know about Passover? Well, I was taught about it at school in my religious education. So yes, I know some of it. I'm staying in Manchester, says Ginny. Oh, I see. Yes, Manchester is a great city, very cosmopolitan. And a couple of times I've stayed in Manchester at the, what's the name of that big hotel in the middle of Manchester? I can't remember the name of it now, but it's a lovely hotel. It's very, very, I think it's one of the tallest buildings in Manchester. Is the name of the chocolate taken from Lady Godiva? Thank you, Garcia. I think it is. I think it has something to do with Lady Godiva. Of course, Lady Godiva was very famous for riding on the back of a horse completely naked as a protest. Yes. Salah says, hello from Algeria and warm salutations to you. Thank you very much, Salah. Warm salutations. That's a nice way of saying hello. Hello from Budapest. Eva is here. Eva, hello to Budapest. And I hope your Wednesday night is going well. I am from Iran, teacher, says Mahdi, Mahdi Zadeh, or Zadi. Hello to you, and a big hello to all those watching in Iran. I know I have many viewers there. Usman is here. Usman, hello to you. Thanks for joining me. I love chocolate, but the crisis is hard. I don't know what you mean by that. Which crisis are you talking about? Can you please show us the big chocolate egg that you are going to give to Mr. Steve? Okay, I will show you, but please, you must keep it a secret. I'm going to show you the egg right now, but don't tell Mr. Steve. Please don't spoil the surprise for Sunday. So here is the egg that I'm going to give to Mr. Steve. I'm going to show you very quickly before he comes back, because he will be back very soon. So just a moment. So there it is. So there is the Easter egg that I will be giving to Mr. Steve on Sunday. And you can see it is the particular brand that I mentioned earlier, Lindor chocolate. It is gorgeous. So there it is. It has an egg and also some small chocolates as well. So this is what I'm giving to Mr. Steve on Sunday for Easter. But please, don't tell him. Don't tell Mr. Steve, okay? I'm going to put it back down here now. I know I'm taking a big risk telling you this. So that is how much I trust you. You see? Can you see how much I trust you? I know that you won't let me down. Isn't that nice? Would you like to have a look at my moon cam? Because the moon is out tonight, and this is something that I thought would be interesting. So this is the actual moon tonight. I filmed it just before I came on live. So this is the view from my window looking up at the moon, and there it is, my almost live moon cam. Almost. So there it is, the moon filmed from my window. You can see that it's almost full. It's almost a full moon. It's also a very chilly night because there isn't much cloud around. So you can see that the moon is very, very clear in the sky. So there it is, a shot of the moon that I filmed just before I came on live. It's true. I think Mr. Steve has just arrived. So don't forget, it's our little secret. Please don't tell Mr. Steve about the Easter egg, please. Please. I'm just showing how much I trust you. Talking of the moon, do you know the difference between these two words? Can you see them? Astrology and astronomy. So there are two words there. Can anyone tell me the difference between those words? Astrology and astronomy. Astronomy. Astrology. There is a difference between these two words. But can you tell me? So the question I'm asking tonight, because it's Easter Sunday, this Sunday. Mr. Duncan, what a beautiful moon. Thank you, Clebson. Yes, we have an almost full moon tonight. It's lovely outside. Sometimes when the moon is full, if you go outside and the moon is out, especially when there is a full moon, it's almost as if it's daylight. It's so bright. You don't need a torch. You don't need to carry a light with you because the moon is so bright. And tonight is one of those nights. It is lovely outside. And of course, moonlight is very, very romantic. Alice, I like taking photos of the moon with my camera to see all the beautiful craters. Astrology deals with the zodiac signs, and astronomy deals with stars and celestial bodies. Am I right? You are right, Alice. Thank you very much for giving me the definitions of those two words. That's very kind of you. Of course, there might be some people who don't know the difference between those words, and that's the reason why I'm mentioning it. Kyrie Das, I don't think I'll share secrets with you, Mr. Steve. You're disclosing them to everyone. Okay, then. Well, I don't. As I said last week, I am very good at keeping secrets. Very good indeed, in fact. I think Mr. Steve has just arrived. So, shh, shh, shh. Okay, okay. Shh, 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 shh. Would you like to have a look at one of my word stops? Now, word stop is a series of lessons that exists on my YouTube channel. So here is one of my word stop lessons. And this particular word is one that has been used a lot during the past few months.
Welcome to the Word Stop. I'm so glad you could stop by. Here is today's word.
Today's word is controversy or controversy. The word controversy is a noun which means a row in response or a negative reaction to something. The strong reaction to something, such as an opinion or an action. His words caused controversy throughout the world. You can create controversy by saying something inflammatory. The words cause anger and outrage among groups of people. A controversy usually involves people with opposing views. One group agrees with or holds the same opinion, while another group disagrees, thus creating controversy. The occurrence of the controversy is described as controversial. A controversial plan, a controversial idea, a controversial film, a controversial speech. Controversial is the adjective form of controversy. The president has announced controversial reforms to the health service. The controversial thing creates controversy. It is controversial because one group objects while another accepts. A person who causes controversy is a controversialist. He or she is a controversial character. The word controversy comes from the Latin word for turn around, which refers to the opposing view or actual disagreement. Synonyms of controversy include altercation, disagreement, dispute, opposition, quarrel, wrangle. CONTROVERSY. Controversy or controversy.
That was today's word stop. See you all again soon, and ta-ta for now.
Yes, it is late and live on a Wednesday night, and it's me, Mr. Duncan, live across the internet. I hope you are having a super duper night. I hope everything is going well. A sad day here in the UK. We said goodbye to one of our most popular entertainers here in the UK, a guy called Ken Dodd. And he was a comedian, a very funny man, and he was in show business for nearly 70 years. Can you imagine being in show business for 70 years? 70. That's incredible, isn't it? So today was his funeral. So lots of people were out in the streets in Manchester. Sorry, in Liverpool, not Manchester, in Liverpool, saying goodbye to Ken Dodd. And I was thinking to myself that there aren't many people like him around anymore. There aren't many people who I would say are long term or people who've been around entertaining people for many, many years. And I was thinking that maybe he is one of the last of those types of entertainers. So a very sad occasion today. And I was thinking that most people these days who are famous are not really famous for anything in particular. They're just famous for being famous. So what about you? What do you think? Do you have any characters or any entertainers in your country who have been around for many, many years, like the one I mentioned just, Ken Dodd, a very funny guy, but sadly he died a couple of weeks ago, and today was his funeral. He was 90, I think 90 years old. Incredible. So Mr. Steve is just around the corner. He is approaching me right now. In fact, I can feel his heat. Can you feel the heat from Mr. Steve? Apparently, some people think that Mr. Steve is hot stuff. I'm not sure what they mean by that. So here he comes, Mr. Steve. Hello there.
Hello, Mr. Duncan. Hot stuff? Who thinks I'm hot stuff?
Well, I've had emails from very excited females. I think that
a manly look.
That might be one of the reasons why we have so many ladies watching the live chat. I think so, because of
I don't think it's me.
Don't you?
But it can't be you.
I'm sure it's not me.
Well, it must be me then.
It must be you. Yes, I think so. So what have you been doing tonight?
I've been rehearsing for our new musical.
A music musical.
Our new comic theatre musical.
Okay.
Called San Marino.
San Marino.
It's about a Spanish Caribbean island.
Okay.
And there are pirates.
Okay.
There is intrigue. There is funny dialogue. There's quite nice songs and lovely harmonies.
Can I ask which accent are you using now? Because you said you were going to use a Caribbean accent, and then you said you wanted to use a pirate accent. So what accent are you going to use now?
The director told me that he doesn't want me to use an accent.
Oh, okay.
But as I'm a main character and I'm a pirate, I don't think I should speak in a posh English accent, seeing as I'll be wearing a pirate, probably have an eye patch on, a puffy shirt.
A puffy?
A guitar and probably a pistol.
Will you have a parrot on your shoulder?
Not quite possibly. It is a comedy after all.
I think so. Yes, that would be great.
I think I need some kind of accent.
Yeah.
So I've got to try and perfect, which is why I've mentioned in the other week.
Do you want my advice?
No.
Oh, okay.
But you can give it anyway. As we're live.
My advice is free. It costs nothing at all. So my advice is probably to go with a more traditional pirate accent rather than Caribbean. I think Caribbean might be very hard to learn.
No, I want to go with a Spanish person speaking English accent.
Okay.
That's the accent I'm looking for. So I want to speak how a Spanish person or maybe someone from Colombia would speak English. That's the accent I'm going for.
Okay.
Because I can't be ooar ooar.
Ooar ooar. No.
You know, pirate, because that's like a, anyway, that's like an English pirate.
Mm.
So I've got to have a sort of a, some kind of Spanish flair to it.
Mm.
Yeah.
I don't know. I think, personally, I think Mr. Steve should stick with O-R.
No, it's not up to me anyway, it's up to the director.
O-R.
In your many experiences of being on stage.
Really?
Yes, I'm sure you're the person to come and ask.
Yes.
Not.
Well, I suppose I'm a kind of performer. What do you think? I'm a performer.
Yes, not you haven't appeared in sort of any shows as such.
You do realize being a teacher is a kind of performance.
Yeah, but you're not putting on an accent or I'm talking about performance in the sense of, you know, a play or a theatre production.
Okay.
Hmm.
So how are the rehearsals going?
Okay. We've only got 12 weeks and it's going on. I don't know how. There's reams of dialogue. Reams, that means lots and lots. Many, lots of pages of dialogue.
Many lines. Reams. Lots of lines of dialogue.
I've got to learn it all.
You know what? I must admit, I'm going to be serious here for a moment. I tell you what really does impress me, Steve. What I never fail to be impressed by the way in which Steve is able to learn and remember all of the lines in the plays and in the things that you do. It's incredible. I am so impressed. And you have a bit of a reputation now, don't you? Steve has a reputation for learning from the book very quickly, and he can put the book down and have everything stored in his brain.
Well, the reason I do that is because I don't like to leave it too late before opening night, because then it calms me down. If I don't know the dialogue and I don't know the songs, then that makes me panicky. I need to learn it very early on so that I can put the book down, as we say, and say the lines without dialogue, because then you can start to develop the character. You can't develop the character if you're peering into a book reading your lines. So learn it, put it down, and then you can do the acting bit.
So I think for you, it's almost like it gives you a sense of security as well.
Yes. Yeah, and you can't interact properly with other actors if you're looking into a book.
No. I agree.
And so get the book down quickly.
I could never do that. I could never. Now, all of his friends who are involved in the shows, in the plays, and the musicals, they are always trying to get me involved. They always say, "Oh, come on, Duncan, have a go. Come on, you would be great on the stage." And I always say no, because deep down, I really know that I would never be able to remember all the lines. I would never be able to put the words into my head and remember them. And of course, I would always want to do my own thing as well. It would be very tempting to go off the script and do my own thing.
Yes, you like to improvise, whereas I have security in the lines. That's what I like. Am I full of beans tonight, says Nicole? Yes. Sort of. Yes, I'm average tonight. Let's see how it goes.
So, hi, Mr. Steve. Yes, Nicole. Mr. Steve, has it been raining a lot here?
There's two screens. Well, what's going on?
Don't get too confused. Anna says, do you like the role of a pirate, Steve?
Yes, I like any role where there is a defined, strong character, because that enables me to really let go.
Okay.
So, yes, I like that. I don't like sort of boring characters. Quite often, because I'm a tenor, quite often you find that their parts in a lot of things, they would sort of take the role of the sort of the romantic role. And they don't often get the big character parts, which I do like doing. So yes.
Well, you've actually starred in quite a few shows now. You've been the main
amateur dramatics,
the main actor. But even if it's amateur, you still have to put all of the work in.
Well, that's the thing. You're absolutely right there.
Yeah.
If you've got a main part, even if it's in an amateur performance, you've still got to learn the same lines as the professional would.
Yes.
And you've got, you know, so the same pressure is there.
Yes, I think so. And you do it for nothing. You don't get paid for it or anything.
Nothing. In fact, no. It costs me money.
Yeah. So that's something that I'm very, very impressed by, is how you can remember all of the lines. And that's the reason why I would never, ever go on the stage. I would never appear in any show.
But anyone can learn lines. Anyone can do it. It's just a matter of committing it to memory. It just needs a lot of work, repeating it, going over and over and over the lines.
Apparently, Clebson plays the guitar.
Oh,
but I like the dissonant notes and rhythm.
The dissonant note, yes.
What's a dissonant note, Steve?
It's one that sort of it really sort of touches your emotions.
Ah, yes.
Yes, it's sort of, you know, you get that little, oh, and you can feel it.
Yes,
feel a dissonant note.
A lot of modern love songs have those dissonant notes, don't they?
They do, yes, exactly.
apparently, because of Mr. Steve's...
It means that they're not quite in harmony. They're sort of slightly out of harmony.
We're moving on because we're busy on the live chat.
Oh, yes.
Gosia, apparently, because of your role as the pirate, a lot of people think that maybe you like to drink rum.
Oh, not on stage.
maybe afterwards.
Maybe afterwards, yes.
Or even before.
Mr. Duncan, did you see the game, says Clebson, between Brazil and Germany?
Yes, I heard about it, but I didn't see it. But who won? Because I thought that Brazil won. Did Brazil win? I'm not sure, but I thought Brazil won. And of course, Russia were playing as well, weren't they?
Ooh.
So
any Russians watching tonight? Don't worry, we won't expel you from the live chat. Get it?
I didn't say that, Steve did.
It's a joke, it's a joke.
You can send all of the complaints to Mr. Steve, okay?
I'm joking because, you know, what's going on between Russia and the West at the moment.
I was in the garden earlier looking at the moon. The moon is in the sky. Look at that. Isn't that beautiful?
Yes, it's moving.
So that's it. Yes, that's the actual moon. I went outside just before going on and I filmed that in the back garden. So there it is. So that's my almost live moon cam. So there it is tonight.
There we are. Caridas has explained dissonant, discordant, grating, jarring, not in harmony.
Not in harmony. Let's have a look.
That's right.
Oh, there it is. Yes. Discordant, grating, jarring, dissonant, not in harmony. And Thank you, Caridas, for that.
Yes, it means that when you play that note in the chord, it just creates a sort of a normally in songs, it creates that feeling of sort of sadness or pain, you know, or emotion.
Yes.
It's not conveying. It's conveying sort of negative emotions in a song.
I suppose you would hear that sort of music played at funerals.
Maybe a
hymn or maybe a sad bit of classical music. Sard says, hi, Mr. Duncan, my best teacher.
Particular.
I started following your videos since 2010. I appreciate, mate, for your sincere and your dedicated efforts. Thank you, Sard. That's very kind of you.
Brazil won, says Mohammed.
Oh, Brazil did win. Yes, I thought they did. I saw something on the news about it, and yes, I think they did mention, and I think Russia were playing as well, but I can't remember who they were playing against.
Nicole says, Mr. Steve, have you a surprise for our dear Mr. Duncan for Easter? What? It will be a surprise. I'll tell you on Sunday. Oh, Mr. Duncan.
Do you have a surprise?
Oh, well, no, maybe.
Yes. Well, you know what they say? Life is full of surprises. Some of them are nice and some of them not so nice. Shall we have a look at another word stop? This is a series of lessons that explain the meanings of words. And this time we have two words to take a look at.
Mm-hmm.
Two words, diatribe and also déjà vu.
Welcome to the Word Stop. I'm so glad that you've stopped by. Here are today's words.
Today's first word is diatribe. The word diatribe is a noun, which is an aggressive verbal statement against someone or something. The sentences used to attack something verbally without holding back form a diatribe. The critical words used form a bitter and harsh attack on one particular thing. A diatribe may even be violent and abusive. A reactionary speech given in anger can be described as a diatribe. His speech condemning the protesters was nothing more than a long diatribe. We all had to sit and listen to this man's diatribe. Many of Hitler's speeches usually consisted of one long diatribe. The content of a verbal attack on one person or a group is a diatribe. Diatribe comes from the Greek word for rub away. Synonyms of diatribe include attack, denunciation,
harangue, rant, tirade. D-I-A-T-R-I-B-E, diatribe. Today's second word is déjà vu. The word déjà vu is a noun that describes the feeling of having done the same thing before. It names the feeling or sensation of a certain moment of time repeating itself. You feel as if you are living a moment of your past again, exactly as it happened. Déjà vu occurs in the mind, therefore it is a psychological term. You will sometimes experience the feeling of déjà vu as you are doing something for the first time. You have never done that thing before, however, it feels very familiar. As I walked in the room, I had a sudden feeling of déjà vu. The word déjà vu can be used negatively to express boredom towards something. This new TV show gives me the feeling of déjà vu. I am saying that it is unoriginal and has been done before. The word déjà vu comes directly from the French language and means already seen. D-E-J-A-V-U, déjà vu.
That was today's word stop. See you all again soon, and ta-ta for now.
No, it's some kind of strange discoloration.
Yeah, where?
If I were you, just there. Yeah, I think you know. I think you need to see a doctor. Oh, right, we're back on. Oh, hello.
I need to see a doctor. I need to see a doctor. What's a doctor?
A doctor. You'll be fine.
I'll be okay. It's just a slight discoloration. It's nothing.
Yes.
It's nothing serious.
Nothing to do with overexposure to the sun.
I'm sure it's completely benign.
Ooh.
Benign.
Did you just happen to have that there?
I wrote it down very quickly. Did you see me do it very quickly? I can write things down like the Flash. Do you know the superhero, the Flash? I have a superpower where I can write things down very quickly. And there it is, look.
Oh.
Benign. Something benign is gentle, kind, or not harmful. Not harmful. Mr. Steve is trying to find my brain. Apparently, it's in there somewhere. But he told me just that he can see daylight coming from the other side.
I can see lots of wax.
What are you saying? Are you saying I have a waxy ear?
Yes, I'm surprised you can hear anything.
I don't know why.
Disgusting.
Sometimes my wax, I don't know why. Sometimes the wax in my ear smells very nice. I don't
know
why. So do that sometimes and you go, it's like cherry blossom. I don't know why. I'm sometimes very fascinated by my body smells. I don't know why. I'm sure I'm not unusual there. Lots of people secretly like smelling themselves. They do. It's true. It's human nature.
I think we need to discuss that, Mr. Duncan.
I think it's very, very, very common. Very common.
Comments we'll get.
But sometimes my earwax is very lovely. When I was a kid, when I was a child, I used to taste my earwax. I used to actually see what it tastes like. So
what?
I used to take the earwax and taste it. Not recently.
I don't think that's the sort of thing you should admit to millions of people watching around the world.
Millions?
Well, according to that, we've got about 2 million people watching.
2 million people watching?
2 million
mostly
people.
From Brazil, I think.
Oh, I see. Yes, I know. We have a very big fan base.
Aren't you celebrating in Brazil your team winning against what country was it? Who were they playing? Brazil? Forgotten now.
I want to say Germany.
Yes. Ooh, fancy beating the Germans. Fantastic.
Yes. You seem very pleased about that, Steve.
Perhaps you gave them all yellow fever. Because I think you've got a bit of an outbreak of yellow fever in Brazil at the moment.
Why do you sound so happy about this?
Well, perhaps they gave yellow fever to all the German tea so that they couldn't play properly.
Where are you going with this?
They all got mosquito bites, came down with the yellow fever. It's very serious. I shouldn't joke about it.
I know. What?
I'm just rambling.
I know, I can tell. And maybe upsetting people at the same time.
I'm not upsetting anyone. It's just a fact. Okay. There is an outbreak of yellow fever at the moment in South America.
Anna says, I think Mr. Duncan could be a very good singer and also an actor. I'm not sure about actor, but some people say that I have a very good singing voice. Yeah.
You do, Mr. Duncan, you do.
Oh, thank you very much. The opposite of benign is malign. Yes. Yes, I suppose you could say that malign, malignant.
Malignant,
so
yes.
So something that is very active or harmful is malignant. Quite often we use those two words when we are diagnosing cancer or tumours. So when we are talking about something that is growing on a person's body, they will often do some sort of test to see if it's harmful or not, whether or not it is benign or malignant. Malignant.
You don't want to hear a doctor say to you, you've got a tumour and it's malignant.
You never want to hear that sentence.
You never want to hear that.
You never want to hear that ever. Natalia says, do you believe in astrology? I don't. I don't. I know a lot of people like to follow their star sign. Particularly people who believe in that sort of thing. They want to know whether their day is going to be good or not. So they normally read their horoscope. And that is all to do with astrology. So there is a difference between those two things. Astrology and astronomy. As we mentioned earlier, there is a definite difference. Yes, Steve?
Ernesto says that, did you know San Marino is a little independent republic in Italia? I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either.
But I did think that there was an Italian football team called San Marino. It just happens that this particular musical is called San Marino.
San Marino, San Marino.
And, you won't find it anywhere on the internet.
Oh, I see.
Looked it up. There's nothing about it at all. It was written about 100 years ago.
So this show that you're in is like an exclusive.
Yes, apparently it was popular in its day, but hasn't been performed for many, many years.
Oh, here's a good one. This yes. one might be for you, Steve, because you've had Polish friends in the past.
Yes.
Gretzwi says, Mr. Duncan, have you ever tried Polish meals or Polish food? Have you ever tried it? Well, I haven't.
I'm not sure that I have.
Well, maybe Gretzu, you can tell us what type of food Polish food is. I would be quite interested to find out.
Alice says, what are our star signs?
Oh, well, I'm Leo the Lion.
And I'm Aquarius.
I thought you might be Virgo. Steve.
Virgo intacta.
I think it's been a long time since Steve's been Virgo. I love astronomy, says Sergio. I work in an astronomical observatory as a science communicator.
Fantastic.
That's amazing. Ooh,
what a fantastic job.
So you will really appreciate, my lovely moon cam tonight. There it is, almost live. It isn't live, but I filmed it earlier, just before going on to my live stream.
We've got a telescope, haven't we?
We have, but it's in the loft.
It's in the loft.
It's in the attic in pieces.
I used to have one when I was young because I used to love astronomy, and I had not quite inexpensive reflector telescope. Sergio will know what a reflector telescope is. I used to observe all the moons of Jupiter. Oh, it was fascinating. I used to write them out in my book. And I bought an inexpensive telescope for Mr. Duncan a number of years ago. We can see, you looked at the moons of Jupiter here, the rings of Saturn.
Mm-hmm.
But it's not a very powerful, so they only look about that big. But you can still see them. It's fascinating.
I think we might have a slight technical problem here.
What?
Because this is all locked up again. We had this problem last week.
Can you hear us?
I think we're still on the live chat, but we can't now operate the encoder, unfortunately. It's now stuck on the moon. So, not literally on the moon. We're not on the moon at the moment, but unfortunately, the encoder that I use has decided to completely lock up, and now I can't even do anything with it, which is slightly, just ever so slightly, annoying.
Shall I use my fat fingers and just go and randomly press them on your keys over there?
No, I don't think it will. I don't think it will do anything, to be honest. I think that's it. I think we're stuck.
Can everybody still hear us? Can somebody say, yes, you can hear us, please?
Can you still
so that we know.
Hear us? The moon will stay on the screen now for the next few moments. But everything else now doesn't work. That's really annoying.
Clebson says he's going to buy a telescope.
A telescope.
Is that a policeman? Kind of policeman.
Yes. Hilarious. Sergio, amazing images of the moon. I promise to send you some images we take with our telescope. Well, I tell you, Sergio, you're going to see that moon shot for quite a while now, because
sound is okay. We can be heard. That's good. Thank you for letting us know.
You can hear us, but unfortunately, this is a problem that I've had for a while now, and I don't know why we have this problem, but it's very, very annoying.
Mr. Duncan is frantically trying to fix whatever's going on.
I already know deep down that this isn't going to work. It's just something that happens, and once it happens, there is nothing you can do to change
it. If I prepared a song, I could have sung it.
Yes.
To entertain people while you are trying to fix what is it you're trying to fix?
I'm trying to make the encoder work.
The encoder.
Unfortunately, it's locked up, completely locked up on the screen.
I think you need a new encoder, Mr. Duncan.
So people can see us, but they can't hear us. So that's good.
No, they can hear us.
Yes, I know. They can hear us, but not see us.
They can't see us.
Well, no. That's what they're seeing at the moment, is that still shot of the moon.
Oh, I see.
That's it.
You can't see us.
No, that's it. That's the live output, Steve.
Oh, right. Well, I don't know all these technical things.
You've only been doing it for nearly a year, but, you know.
Well, yeah, but I don't normally see the control centre, the nerve centre.
Anyway, I'm enjoying the moon and hearing you. It's okay. Well, it isn't okay for me, because it means everything's locked up. So now I can't do anything else. You can't see us either. It's very, very annoying.
Why don't you go over to your main control over there?
It doesn't make any difference, Mr. Steve, unfortunately. It's the same control. It doesn't actually make any difference.
You've got a new computer as well.
It isn't anything to do with the computer. It's the software. There has been an update on the software, and ever since the software has been updated, it hasn't worked properly. This is X-Split.
What a load of rubbish.
Well, Steve says that, not me. But yes,
it's let you down several times.
It is slightly annoying, I will be honest with you.
We have to get to the bottom of it.
Well, we do, because now we are kind of stuck with this image of the moon. Natalia says, I do hear you. Thank you very much, Natalia. Unfortunately, you can't see us, but you can hear us. It's a bit like radio.
Yes, let's pretend it's radio.
So welcome. If you just tuned in, this is Radio Duncan, and my special guest on tonight's chat show on the radio is Mr. Steve. Mr. Steve, tell us, are you enjoying that picture of the moon?
Well, yes. Of course, I saw it for real as I came in tonight.
For real?
One Love says...
Have you ever been to the moon?
It's not natural. Yeah, that is a real picture, One Love. that Duncan took earlier with his camera.
Yes.
I bet he's regretting it now, because it means that I'm still looking at the camera as though people are watching it.
Yes. Steve is still moving as if he's on camera, even though no one can see us.
I think I'll just strip off. No one will know, will they?
Yes, I'll know. And that's bad enough.
How long have you been on, Mr. Duncan?
I can't even tell you that now, unfortunately. This is about an hour and 10 minutes. Now, because we are stuck in this weird state of not being able to actually. Yes. So now this is stuck. We can't do anything else. We are literally a prisoner, thanks to XSplit. I'm thinking of cancelling my subscription to XSplit and finding something else to use.
Yes, it's let you down several times recently.
It's really been terrible. Yes, they keep updating these things, and every time they update it, it stops working. Yes. Nicole Jeffrey says, what is the Cambridge Analytica and what is the problem with Facebook? It's a very complex thing to explain, but basically it is all about the way in which people's information is being used to target people who use Facebook, and that's it, really. That's basically it.
Yes. And so Facebook's an American company, isn't it?
Oh yes. Well, that's immaterial. Whether they're American or not is immaterial.
Yes, but Nicole was asking. But Cambridge Analytica is a British company.
Yes, Cambridge Analytica is a company that they take figures and facts and behavior, people, the things people like, the things people do, and then they convert them into algorithms. That means they work out who does what, who likes what, who is a fan of what. And they've been working in association with Facebook, which is an American company, and they've been providing them with information to allow them to target users on Facebook. But besides that, and this is where the problem occurs, they've also been using information of not just the people that they've accessed, but also their friends as well. So they've also taken the information of the people on their friend list as well. So people who are completely unaware of the situation have also been targeted. So they have no idea. And that's where the problem arises.
Yeah. So the Mark Zuckerberg, is it the chief executive or owner of Facebook?
He is.
Has been asked by the British government. I mean, get this. He's been asked by the British government to appear before the Parliamentary Select Committee and explain why all this information has got out.
Yeah.
And he's refused to do it. He didn't want to come and do it. He's obviously too frightened, or thinks that it's he doesn't need to do it. But I think he may have to change his mind. He's been asked again, apparently, tonight. Well, put it this way, Facebook shares have dropped dramatically.
They have.
Over the last few days as a result of this, because they're fearing lots of new regulations may come into play for companies such as Facebook. And it's interesting that Facebook have announced tonight that they've updated all their privacy settings.
Mm. Yes.
I mean, why couldn't they have done that before? Suddenly, yes, they're able to do it almost overnight.
But this is always the way. What we always say is a person will always get away with something until they are found out. And that is it. So the crime isn't doing it. The crime is getting caught doing it. And of course, once you're caught doing it,
yes,
then the situation tends to change somewhat.
And then all you have to say is, I apologize. Lessons have been learnt.
Or lessons will be learnt.
And that's what they usually say. And they've known all along.
It was a mistake. It was an administration error. It was a person who works in an office somewhere else in the building, and we didn't realize. So there are lots and lots of excuses that people use nowadays. We have a list of excuses that people have prepared just in case. They get caught.
Yes, exactly. Oh, yes, Clebson says Mr. Steve Mark didn't go. No, he didn't go, but he may have to go.
Yes. they may summon him.
But never mind. Well, people seem to like this idea of doing a sort of a radio podcast.
Yes, but it's very odd that they're staring at an image of the moon. It's almost like that's where we are broadcasting from. We are now live on the moon.
Blender says, why don't you translate in English what you are talking? Well, we'd have to be very fast typers in order to do that.
Yes.
Blender. And so we can't do that, unfortunately.
But later on, there will be subtitles on the video. I hope there will be subtitles later, thanks to YouTube and their lovely automatic subtitles. But that will be coming later. I think we will leave it there, Steve, because this really does feel very strange, standing in front of a computer that is now locked up. It's also very unnerving, and I'm not quite sure how I'm going to stop this either.
Aurora says, I'm just seeing the moon. Is it correct? No, it isn't. Something's gone wrong with Mr. Duncan's system.
It's not the computer.
Yeah, I know. I'm just, yeah.
Yes, just before.
I know, I didn't say computer.
But you nearly did.
I nearly did, but I didn't. But now you've said it, so it's the point.
But you nearly said computer.
Yeah, something has gone wrong.
With the software.
With the software. So you can't see us at the moment.
Yes, it's very, very annoying.
So I think we're going to go, aren't we, Mr. Duncan?
Without the picture, I can concentrate on your conversation.
Yes, people seem to like it.
Well, maybe from now we will just do the live stream in the dark. So we'll have the camera, but we will just switch the lights off, and then you can just listen to us talking in the dark.
Yes, perhaps people could pretend that they're having listening to a telephone conversation or the radio,
albeit a very boring one.
Never mind.
Not to worry. I think we will wrap it up there because I need to find out what is actually going on here. I also need to work out how to stop this because I can't actually stop the stream now because the encoder has locked up. And needless to say, I will be sending a very, very stern message to XSplit for once again letting me down with their terrible, terrible software, which seems to be full of bugs. There are lots of bugs in this software, I think. Aurora says, thanks for your answer. Oh, okay, that's okay.
Well, I'm glad you could understand us, Aurora.
What idioms are to do with the word moon are the most common? Well, we can say over the moon, also once in a blue moon. So if you are over the moon, it means you are very, very happy. Very, very happy.
Mr. Duncan at the moment is not over the moon.
At the moment, I do not feel over the moon because my lovely encoder... I'm being ironic there, by the way. My lovely encoder has decided to lock up and does not work. I think we have the moon to thank for that. Maybe it's something to do with the gravitational pull of the moon. It's affecting my software.
Perhaps it is.
Anyway, Steve, I think we'll leave it there.
Okay.
I'm going to get a very large hammer. Maybe you can change the system. Do you have Windows 10? Yes, I have Windows 10. In fact, this computer that I'm using is brand new. It actually has the latest Intel processor, the 8700K processor. And it also has a top-of-the-range graphic card. So it's not the problem with the computer. It is actually the problem with the encoding software. It has a big problem. And as you can see, because of that, we now have to sit and stare at a slightly blurry image of the moon.
So the encoder, is that the software that allows people to see us?
That's the software that converts whatever is going on into a signal that then can be transmitted across the internet.
Okay, so it's a vital piece of software.
It is the most vital.
So it's the main bit of software that enables the whole thing to work, really.
Yes, without the encoder, you have no live stream.
Right, okay.
So it's very important.
Time to ditch XSplit and go with someone else.
Yes, I need to find out if there is someone else that does that does software for encoding. Of course, you can buy professional encoding, but it's incredibly expensive. It's about $1,000 a month.
Right.
Can you believe that, Steve?
You need quite a few donations.
Yes.
In order to be able to use that.
Professional encoding is incredibly expensive. So that's the reason why I use XSplit. Even though, having said that, I still have to pay for XSplit. I still have to pay them a yearly subscription.
Thank you, Alice. And thank you, Anna. And bye to you both, too. Yes, Julia. Sorry, we're going to have to go because there's a problem with the connection through to the internet, so
yes.
You can't see us.
Well,
you
the
can
connection's
hear us.
Okay. It's just the software.
Yes, I think we've explained that.
Okay, then. So we're going to go now, and we will see you later. This is Mr. Duncan and
Mr. Steve
saying, "I'm very sorry about the technical problem. I'm going to write a very angry letter to XSplit right now, and I will see you on Sunday. Hopefully we'll be here. It's Easter Sunday.
We will be here.
And of course it's April Fool's Day as well.
Oh, so we you can only play a trick on somebody before 12 o'clock.
Yes, before midday
on April's Fool's Day.
So if you play the trick after midday, then the fool or the joke is on you, the person that actually played the joke. Thank you, Belarusia, Sukat, Alice, Klebsum, Anna, Julia, and we will see you on Sunday, hopefully. I really hope we will be here on Sunday. If not, then we always have the moon to look at.
Maybe, yes. You may not be able to get rid of it. It may be here forever.
Yes, this might be burnt onto my computer screen forever, this image of the moon.
Klebsen says one day maybe we're going to live on the moon.
Yes,
we may do.
We
yes.
might we might live on the moon or even under the moon.
Ooh,
wow.
Well, we'll be over the moon to see you all again on Sunday.
Yes, what a great place to leave. So we'll see you on Sunday and hopefully everything will be okay. This is Mr. Duncan and Mr. Steve saying thanks for watching and at the moment listening to us live on YouTube. And of course, you know what's coming next. Yes, you do. I'm waving now, by the way. Ta-ta for now. Ta-ta for now, Steve.
Ta-ta for now.
Ta-ta for now. Is there anyone there? Hello. Is there anyone there watching live? I'm not sure, actually, but anyway, I'm just saying a quick hello and apologies. What I did is I closed the encoder, then opened it again, almost shutting down the whole computer. But apparently, if you restart the encoder quickly enough, it will actually just add it on to the actual live stream. So we're back for a few moments just to apologize once again for the slight problem with the encoder. I will be getting on to XSplit and telling them all about it. Mr. Steve at the moment is clearing his throat. Very interesting.
I was just gargling because so I got something like a cold coming or something tonight. I felt a bit feverish.
It's very strange because my throat earlier was very dry as well. I was it felt like everything was cracking up in my throat. It felt tight. But I think it's just the air. The air at the moment is very strange. I think everything in the atmosphere at the moment is all over the place.
My back all sort of aches. Sort of, you know, when you feel as though you've got a fever or something coming on. That's how I felt tonight.
Ah.
So, you know, hope you don't catch this.
Charming.
Is anyone watching?
I don't know if anyone's actually here, but
I've probably all gone to bed.
We are live, back live, and this is actually the same stream. All I've done is rejoin the same stream that was actually there. So I hope you can see us. Shall I put the moon on again?
Put the live chat on to see if anyone's watching us. Don't put the moon on again. That's what made it go wrong before.
Wait a moment. Let's see if we can get the live chat working. This is great. So maybe this is something I can do in the future. If it goes wrong again, maybe I can just sort of close the XSplit, then just reopen it straight away. And then it just continues on the live stream.
Clebson's notice we're back.
Thank you, Clebson, for your loyalty there.
you stayed with us through thick and thin.
Thick and thin. That means that you are not a fair weather friend. You are a person that will stay with someone no matter what happens.
Even if it goes right or if it goes wrong, you'll still stick with us.
However bad things get. So yes, we are back. We managed to, well, what I did, and this is something that I will do in future, I just closed the actual program by going into the, you know, I'm not going to explain all of this, but then I restart the encoder and then suddenly we're back on again. So that's amazing.
I was hoping to go to bed.
Steve was already taking his clothes off. He was already putting his nightcap and his nightshirt on.
I've got my candle lit. You know, I was going to go up the stairs with my candle.
We don't want to know about your candle.
It's made of wax.
Okay, then. Like the wax in my ear, maybe.
The moon is gone. Yes, the moon won't be coming back. I think the moon caused all the problems.
I never want to see the moon again.
Oh.
Forever.
It's cloudy. The moon's now obscured by clouds.
Yes, I'm sorry. You can't see the moon again. I'm not showing it. It's too risky.
My voice is all, it's, you know, it's like I've got a throat infection or something.
No, you'll be fine. Every week, Steve thinks he's got something wrong with him.
I do.
It is.
I'm a hypochondriac.
I think you are. I think you're a bit of a hypochondriac.
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 Hypochondriac. Somebody who thinks that there's always something wrong with them. We've all met people like that, and you've just met another one. I've revealed something else about myself to the world, Mr. Duncan, that I'm constantly worrying about my health.
Marco is here. Hello, Marco has just arrived. Isn't that strange? Well, Marco, you have missed all the drama because my encoder, the encoder which allows my live stream to actually work, had a problem. And then I just disconnected it and started it again. So there we go. So I'm actually back after a slight technical problem. Clebsum says the moon is gone. Yes. Can we restart our lives? Says Cardass. Wouldn't that be lovely?
Wouldn't that be lovely? You could just press a reset button and just start again.
Wouldn't that be great? You can get to about 23 or 24 and you think, I don't like this life. I want to start it again, and then you just press a button. But of course you can only do it once, so you can only reset your life one time.
Is this a rule you've just made up?
No, that's it. Well, there's no point doing it again and again, because every time something trivial happens, you would just keep resetting it. So you can only reset your life one time. This sounds like a science fiction story. In the future, human beings have the ability to reset their lives.
I don't see why you should be setting the rules on they can on reset.
Only, I'm the author of this story.
No, it wasn't. It was somebody else.
It's my idea. Copyright.
Somebody else said they was it.
Copyright 2018.
Mrs. got rid of their live chat again. I can't see.
Mister. Who's Mister?
No, you, Mr. Duncan.
All right, I see.
That's right.
I'm so glad you came back.
Caridas.
Ultimus.
Caridas.
Ultimus. Something is wrong, I believe. The chat is online, but the video and audio isn't. Oh, I see. That doesn't make sense. So actually, you can't hear us.
Can you hear us? Can you hear us?
Are we actually coming through? I'm sure we are. I'm pretty sure we are. If not, we'll have to just write things down and just hold it up in front of the screen. Well, according to my encoder, we are actually sending out a video signal and an audio signal as well. So I hope that you can see and hear us. What? Oh, that's, yeah, there's no point doing that because the focus is locked. Your writing is so terrible that nobody can see that. Can you hear us? Oh, restart. It seems okay.
Yes.
Yes, Mr. Duncan, I can see and hear you. So why was someone saying that they couldn't?
Perhaps.
You may need to refresh your page. You might need to refresh the page that you're on. That might be something to do with it. So you might need to refresh the page. So click whatever it is to refresh the page. Make it reappear.
Somebody tell him or her.
Give them a nudge.
On the live chat, tell them how to refresh.
I could do with refreshing myself, to be honest. Wouldn't that be lovely?
Yes, that is interesting. I've often thought, you know, sometimes if you're getting all tense and upset during the day at work, the equivalent of pressing the reset button in your computer is to go for a nice sleep. Sleep often resets you, doesn't it? It's like pressing a reset button.
Yes.
Because when you go to sleep at night, your brain is sifting through all that information that we've taken in during the day, and it's sorting it out into things that are important. If they're important things, it'll stick them in the memory. If they're unimportant things, it's discarding them. Apparently that's what the brain's doing at night, and that's why sleep's so important. It's managing all that information that's coming in through our ears, our eyes, our noses, everywhere.
That's it,
because we can only store so much
in one day,
and we need those 8 hours for the brain to sort out and get rid of all the trash.
See, I don't need that, because I've got a little slot in the back of my head. I just put an SD card in the back, you see. So I just get a little card and put it in the back of my neck and then take it out, and then I just put another one in, you see. So I don't need to do that.
Perhaps you need to tell me where the on off button is. I'd like to know where that is.
So yes, a very interesting
joking.
A very interesting idea. Clebson says refresh. Yes, refresh. Refresh.
I'm refresh.
Refresh means to renew. You start again, or you reset something. You refresh or reset. So in computer jargon or computer terms, so it means to reset. You refresh or reset. Yes, I'm online. Thank you, Mr. Duncan. Yes, I refreshed and now it's okay. You see, I was right. I was right. I know so much about computers. It's true. I'm very good. If ever anyone around here, we have a neighbor who comes around sometimes, and sometimes I have to help her with her computer. So thank you, Ultimus, for that. I don't know how many people are watching at the moment. Goodness knows.
Are we down to maybe 500,000 now?
I think maybe just 500,000 people are watching now. Mr. Duncan, the way you speak, it seems like you've been taken by aliens. Well, yes, maybe I have.
Maybe the sound is strange.
I don't know. Who knows?
How would we know?
We won't know. That's the problem.
Have we been taken by aliens?
Maybe we have. Maybe that image of the moon attracted some aliens and maybe they came down and took us away. Maybe now we are on a ship flying away to another planet and maybe they are taking our trousers down at this very moment and they are preparing to probe us. Probe.
Well, I can probe them because I've got my magnifying glass. Get away, you aliens.
Get away. Maybe not.
Oh. We're not, by the way.
We're not aliens.
I've just looked out of the window. It looks perfectly normal.
41 people are watching at the moment. So shall we go? Now we can say goodbye properly. We will go. So thanks for tuning back in.
There's a good word. Marco says you are savvy.
Savvy. Oh, yes. I like that word. If you are very savvy, it means you are very familiar with something. You have the knowledge. You have some skill. You are able to do something. You are very familiar with something. You are savvy.
Mr. Duncan is very savvy with computers.
I'm very savvy with computers.
He's very good. Knows what he's doing.
Especially audio and visual technology.
You've got a lot of it here. You're very savvy when it with tripods.
This room
Mr.
is...
Mr. Duncan, have you told your viewers that you bought yet another tripod?
I bought a little tripod, but it wasn't new. It was a charity shop, and I saw it in the window, and I couldn't resist buying it.
Duncan collects tripods like most people would collect shoes.
I don't collect tripods. I use them. Tripods are... invaluable.
Before I'm going to add them up.
If you have a studio.
1, 2, 3.
Steve's
four,
now adding up my five, tripods.
6, 7.
Tripods.
8. I'll be back. 9.
Yes, this is fascinating, Steve. I'm sure the 31 people watching are really interested in finding out how many tripods I have in my studio.
Well, I've counted 16, but I know you've got more than that because it was 18 before. I think it's 19 now. Yeah.
Well, there are 4 more behind us holding up all of the scenery.
That's 19 then.
You had to use your fingers to work that out.
I always do that.
You had to use your fingers then.
That was just for the benefit of the viewers.
I thought for a moment you was going to get a calculator out or phone a mathematician up.
Yeah. It's a trip hazard, I'll tell you. You couldn't let anybody in here without getting some kind of liability insurance.
What?
Because people would trip up everywhere.
Well, no one ever comes into this studio, only me and sometimes Mr. Steve, and that's it. I don't like anyone else coming in here. This is my private sanctuary.
I insured?
It's a bit like Superman. This is my fortress of solitude.
If I was to trip up over a tripod, Mr. Duncan, are you insured? Would I be able to claim
compensation? No, I would. I would bury you somewhere and people would never find you.
Well, I'm not expecting to die by tripping over one of your tripods. Maybe just, you know, a broken foot.
Yes.
A banged head.
That's what you would start off with. But if it involves some sort of claim on insurance, then I don't see things ending very well for you.
I'll tell you, if we ever, and touch wood, had a break-in, and anyone tried to come in your studio, we'd know they were here because we'd just hear crashing and banging.
Well,
they'd never get anywhere.
Well, not now. You've just told them.
Well, they trip up over. There's tripods everywhere.
Yeah, but Steve, you've just told people that they're there.
I know. Yeah, but if it's dark, won't see them.
Yeah, but they won't now. They'll plan for breaking in, and they'll say there are tripods everywhere. We better get those night glasses so we can see the tripods.
I don't think anyone's watching who would want to break in.
Who knows? Mark Zuckerberg might be watching. He might be short of money in a few weeks' time when Facebook crashes to the ground. Who knows?
Yes, I'm trying to work out how much all these tripods cost in your studio.
Really?
Yes. Fascinating. I reckon there's about £400 worth of tripods.
Mario says, sometimes in life it happens. Always there are things you can't control. The important thing is to take advantage in a creative way. You guys did very well. Thank you, Mario, for that.
Thank you, Mario.
Thank you very much.
As we say at work, yeah, you're absolutely right. There are, you can plan for lots of things, and then suddenly the unexpected comes along. And sometimes the unexpected is something you can't do anything about. So, as we tend to say at work, control what you can control.
Mm.
So, just deal with what you can control and then stop worrying about the stuff you can't control.
That was today's thought for the day with the Reverend Mr. Steve. When I'm talking, you know, you wait until I finish the sentence and then you talk. It's very complex.
We'll have to practice.
We have been for about a year. Dear me. So
do you want me to explain what tomorrow is in the Holy Week?
Tomorrow? In the Holy Week tomorrow?
The Holy Week that started on Sunday for religious people watching. This week is Holy Week, is it not? For Christians. Well,
you've mentioned it three times just.
Yes,
so
there must be Christians watching. Yes. And even if there aren't, people from other religions may be interested because they might think, what's going on with Christians this week? They're off to church all the time. They're celebrating this, that and the other. So I thought I'd just,
That was that. Well, when I woke up this morning, I thought, well, I wonder what Christians are doing today.
But it's a special week for Christians.
It is.
It, this week, yes.
So tomorrow is what is it tomorrow then, Steve?
Tomorrow. So on Sunday it was the.
Because tomorrow is just Thursday.
Tomorrow is just Thursday, but in the Holy Week,
okay,
leading up to Easter Sunday, it's called Maundy Thursday.
Maundy Thursday.
Maundy Thursday.
So why?
Because that was according to the Bible. That was when Jesus had his Last Supper with his disciples, his 12 disciples, and he washed their feet.
So he washed their feet?
Yes.
Okay.
As a sign of suppliance.
Suppliance?
Yes. You wouldn't expect somebody like that. If you wash somebody's feet.
Well, is that the same as subservience?
Sort of, yes. In a word, it's saying, look, I'm the boss, but, you know, I can still wash your feet because I can do these things. I'm not high and mighty.
This is all too heavy for me. It's quarter to midnight.
I know, but that's just what it is. I'm not saying whether I think it's true or not.
Well I didn't ask.
Lots of people, you know, that's something that people will be thinking about tomorrow.
OK, so what's Friday then?
Friday's Good Friday.
Good Friday.
It's called Good Friday on Friday, but that's when Jesus was crucified, of course.
Well, that doesn't sound very good.
Oh, no, he died on the Friday, didn't he? That's it.
You're telling me.
He died on the Friday and then was resurrected on the Sunday.
Okay.
Well, and it wasn't Sunday then. It could have been any day.
Yes, you seem very specific there about the days of the week.
That's just what it's called.
Okay.
That's what, you know. And I'm not saying that, you know, I necessarily believe in the... just relaying the information.
Please bear in mind that it's Steve.
Anyone commenting? Please, I want the comments.
I'm not sure about commenting. They might be doing more than commenting.
We're not particularly religious people, but it's nice to know what's going on.
I am not.
Don't you agree?
Well, I've never made a secret of the fact that I'm not religious.
Yes.
Even though I talk about religion sometimes at Christmas, for example. But I'm not a religious person.
It's a nice story. Do you know, I was singing on Monday because we had a little, wouldn't say a concert on Monday, a celebration, sort of a concert on Monday. Oh, yes. You can tell I was getting ready for bed.
Steve is semi-naked, by the way. He's got no trousers.
Say that, semi-naked.
He's got no trousers or pants on.
So we were asked by a local church, the choir that I'm in, we were asked if we would sing some songs for their Easter service, which they had on Monday. So we sung about five songs, which anybody who goes to sort of Christian churches would probably recognise them. And typical things that are sung at Easter. There was a few readings. There were so some members of the congregation came up and did readings. Then there were hymns. And then we in the choir sung some individual pieces as well. And, you know, I was singing one of the songs and I felt all sort of, very sort of emotional as I was singing it, Mr. Duncan. And I thought, what's going on here? Because the words were so touching. Sometimes when you, sometimes you go to the rehearsals and you just sing it. And then, but when you, and then you don't really think much of it. And suddenly if you actually read the words, whether you believe the story or not, it's actually quite, well, I felt quite sort of, I don't know, like I once said, like I had a spiritual
But can I just say
experience?
I think it's very similar though to when you go into a church, because of the fact that these buildings are very solid, they're built with very solid brick or stone. So when you go inside, of course you can't hear the sounds from outside. So it always feels when you go into a church that you're entering into a different sort of, almost a different universe. It has a very special feeling. And I think sometimes people can interpret that with some sort of other meaning.
Well, this was different because it was the music.
Yes, I understand what
the
you mean, but
organ was playing.
That's it. Yes, but it's a combination of atmosphere or noise or sound or certain notes, as we said earlier. Certain notes can have an effect.
Certain chords
on your emotions.
Where's the live chat, Mr. Duncan?
Where's the live
I
chat?
Know what people are saying.
The live. I think everyone's gone. Oh, yes. Clebsum says, Mr. Duncan, could you say hi to my son, Kevin Gabriel? Yes, I will. There we go.
Caridas has made a very important point there. Religion is not the same as faith or belief. Yes.
Or credence.
You can believe in something. Like, for example, you can believe in God, but you don't have to be religious.
Hmm.
Because the religion is the organized... the organized worship,
the doctrine,
so to speak. Yes,
the organized doctrine,
yes,
is religion. So any organized doctrine is basically religion. So yes,
I know a lot of people who believe in God, but they don't practice any particular religion because they don't believe in everything that comes with the religion.
Some people, of course, believe bits and then they leave other bits out.
Yes.
And then there's that bit I believe, that bit's quite good. That bit I don't like, I'll forget about that bit. But that bit, yeah, I'll keep that.
Yeah.
And then they sort of swap. It's almost like putting clothes on. You decide which parts of the religion you want to wear.
We could get very controversial, but I think we ought to probably...
I don't think it's controversial, because I've talked about these things anyway in the past.
But they always say, don't they, if you're with a group of friends, never talk about religion or politics.
Mm.
Because that's an expression. Never talk about, don't talk about religion or politics.
Or Mr. Duncan's encoder.
Because if you do, it always tends to cause arguments. Because people have very strong views and then you can fall out so quite often if you're in it with a group of people and you start talking about religion or politics, someone will say, no, let's not talk about that because we'll only have arguments.
Of course, the new subject here is also Brexit, you see. So don't talk about politics, religion or Brexit. Definitely not. So there we go. I think. Well, who would have thought that tonight would have turned into this? You just never know. And that's one of the things I like about this late and live.
Anything can happen.
Yes, anything. Sometimes Mr. Steve will do that and burst my eardrum.
You wouldn't expect me to do something like that.
I would actually. Yes, I definitely would.
Why can't I see the live chat? I like to see the live... Mr. Duncan sometimes likes to keep the live chat away from me.
Well, I don't keep it away. It's just that we can only have it on the screen at certain times.
There we go. Yes, Mario in Brazil, of course, Catholic country, Holy Week here, most of the people celebrate it.
Yes, that's it. Well, there's a live chat, Steve, for you.
Yes, I know. I like to see it.
There it is.
Politics. Somebody's put, Ultimus has put question mark politics. It's politicians, parliament.
Well, anything to do with this decision making or opinions.
Yes, because people always, different parties in countries like here, we've got Conservatives or Labour. You're either one or the other, and people always argue. Well,
yes, it's corners. So when we talk about politics, it's corners. It's corners that people sit in or stay in. So they all have their own opinions. And then people that share the same opinions group together. So some people believe in freedom. Some people believe in control. Some people believe that everyone should be equal. And some people believe that there should be strict rules, or that only a few people should have wealth. So it just depends, really.
Yes. Caridas has said people should be able to respect one another and love one another, even if they believe have different religions. Of course they should. We would all get on perfectly all right with different religions. This is my opinion, by the way.
By the way, well, you haven't noticed that one of our friends is actually on the live chat.
Martin. Oh, hello, Martin.
Hello, Martin.
I've never known us to be live.
Hello, Martin.
When we've got a friend online. Just to finish what somebody was saying there.
Do you have to?
Yes, because I think it was an important point. It vanished off here, so I'm trying to bring it back up. Yes, there we go. Caridas says, people should be able to respect, even love, the other person whose religion or politics are different. Yes, they should. But the problem is that these religious, all these different religions... and have their leaders, and it's their leaders that try and pit one religion against another. We'd all get on perfectly all right, but then these leaders come up and start saying stupid things, and then we all start fighting each other.
Yeah.
Hello again, Martin.
I'm not sure if any of that has added to the conversation.
I think it has.
Yes, anyway. I hope you like orange.
It's good to see our messages makes us closer. Yes.
Why did you ignore my comments in Arabic? I just said hello. Well, I don't read Arabic. If you write it in Arabic, I won't understand it.
I'll have a look and then we'll recognize it next time.
Thank you, Reem. Well, there it is. It's on the screen now. There it is.
Hello.
There it is, you see?
Oh. Well, now we know what hello in Arabic is.
That's it. Will you remember that, Steve?
Well, I'll try.
Okay, then. So, no, I wasn't ignoring your message. I just couldn't read it. So it's good to see our messages. It makes us feel closer. Thank you, Clebson, for that. Yes, no problem. So earlier we had a slight technical problem. Then I stopped the stream and then restarted it. But it's still the same stream, if that makes sense. So Mr. Steve is really into the live chat. I've noticed this.
Martin will be very impressed seeing me with all this technology around me, just looking as though I'm very confident.
I doubt that very much. I doubt it. Ooh. Is religion the same as spirituality? Well, again, it's subjective. All of these things are subjective. Some people believe yes. Some people believe no. Some people believe it's a bit of both. So, again, it's all subjective. It's a little bit like liking a certain type of food. Some people like a certain type of food or feel as if they want to eat that certain food, and some people don't. And so it's subjective.
Again, as somebody said before, I think it was Aridas said, you can be spiritual, but you don't have to follow a religion. So it's like believing in God. You can believe in God and not be religious. Because the religious aspect is just of the organization.
Yes. Well, really.
You can be a spiritual person.
You've got agnostic people. Agnostics are people who are kind of open-minded. So they're not going, there isn't, but they're not going, there definitely is. They're kind of keeping their options open. What?
Martin says he's impressed.
Impressed with what?
Oh, me just using all this technology.
Well, you're not using all... I think picking up a mobile phone is not difficult.
I think it was me that caused the stream to go off earlier.
I think it probably was.
Because normally when I'm around technology, it all goes wrong. My computer's been going all wrong all day today, you know.
Mm.
And it's only me because my colleagues have had no problems at all.
I see.
So, yes, there we go.
Can I just say to Aurora Rauba, if you refresh your page, if you refresh the page.
Refresh.
Oh, don't shout. You don't have to shout.
Just for comic effect.
Yeah, but it's not funny. It's just very annoying for people listening with headphones.
Oh, who's listening with headphones?
Many, many people listen.
Really?
Yes.
Go on then.
You do realise that most people under the age of 20 now have a pair of headphones stuck inside their ears all the time.
We've got no one watching under 20.
There are lots of people, young people.
I'm only joking.
Lots of young people.
If anyone is watching wearing headphones, would you please let us know?
Yes, many people do.
I want to know.
It's just, this is what happens when you do this for 11 years, you see. You learn these things.
I think it's stuck.
What's stuck? It's not stuck.
Oh, right, okay. Just no one's writing any comments anymore.
They've all fallen asleep, I think. Efrain says, very clear, thank you. That's okay. The live is finished. Mr. Duncan isn't here anymore. No, Aurora. If you refresh your page, you will see us. You will see us. You will. But maybe you can't hear us because that's the problem, you see.
Legs are aching.
Martin sings. By the way, Martin is our friend, and he has a very similar interest to Mr. Steve. You are also interested in amateur,
amateur dramatics, musical theatre. And Martin also directs. He also directs plays and pantomimes.
Yes, Pedro is here. Let me. Where there? Pedro is here. Mustn't forget Pedro.
Oh, we're just about to go.
Yes, Pedro is here. I'm late, unfortunately. I think Pedro has been watching his favourite TV show again.
It's a nice photo, by the way. Nice picture of you there.
Ultimus says, "What about your new computer? Are you using it now?" Yes, I'm using the new computer, but unfortunately, there is a certain type of software that has been updated. And since the update, it hasn't been working very well. It seems to be running all right now. But as soon as I do something like open the moon, like that.
Oh, don't do that. It'll lock up again, Mr. Duncan.
No, there you go, you see? Oh. So earlier when I opened the moon, the whole thing locked up. But now it seems to be all right.
I don't like Mr. Duncan's phone.
Why not?
Because it's got buttons all around the edge, and when you pick it up, you accidentally press some buttons you don't mean to.
Yes, it's not like your rubbish iPhone.
Look, it's got buttons all around the edge. You pick it up and you do something.
Steve's iPhone is rubbish. It doesn't work properly. This is the second iPhone that he's had, whereas mine, I've had this for nearly 4 years. I've had this phone 4 years. This is an old Samsung Galaxy S5, so it's nearly 4 years old, this, and now we're on Galaxy S9.
Phone years are like dog years, aren't they?
I don't know.
So if you've got a
but this phone is like something from the 1980s in technology years. It's like a wind-up gramophone. You know, you sort of have a big needle and you...
Actually, there was nothing. I don't think there was anything wrong with my iPhone because it's one that I use for work. Work gave it me to use for work. It's not my own phone.
Work gave it you to use for work?
Yes.
Okay.
And it stopped working, so they sent me a new one. But they didn't. But there was actually nothing really wrong with the other one. It was just the signal wasn't very good here. But anyway, I sent the other one back, didn't I?
So there,
for the record.
So that is not a very good commercial for the iPhone. However,
right.
However, this Samsung Galaxy S5 is 4 years old and it still works perfectly. And the good thing is I get all the new updates as well. So every time they do a nice update, I get the update on my phone, even though this phone is very old now.
Doesn't everybody get updates, Mr. Duncan?
Ah, no, because most people believe that if you get updates on an older phone, those updates won't work, but they do work. So this phone actually works better than it did 4 years ago because of all of the updates inside. So the camera works better now than it did 4 years ago because of the updates. So they've actually improved this camera.
So why buy a new one?
Yeah, so why buy a new one? That's true.
In fact, talking about, we were speaking earlier about technology, about the shares in Facebook dropping because of their problems with all this data sharing. Technology stocks, if you're into stocks and shares, have been dropping today as well, including those for Apple.
Yes.
Have dropped quite a lot because people aren't buying, actually said this, people aren't buying new phones anymore.
No.
Or far less people are, because the phones are very good now.
Mm.
And you can, they've figured out that you can just keep hold of them, get lots of updates, and, you know, unless you really need to impress your friends,
yes,
then you might as well keep the one you've got.
I'd say, well, that's what I've done. I've just explained all of that. I've had this for 4 years. So this is a 4-year-old phone. I've had it since new. I don't even have a contract now. So
no contract.
So this phone is mine, and I just pay a very small amount each month. And because I've been with one particular phone company for so many years now, they give me this most amazing discount. So I now get 18 gigabytes of free data.
Is that a lot, Mr. Duncan?
That is a lot of data, and it's free data. So it costs me less than £20 a month. So I get a lot of data for this.
And phone gets very hot when it's working.
Well, they all do.
Oh, I know. I'm just saying it's had a lot of use.
Yes.
And it's still reliable.
This phone has been in so many places and used in so many ways. So, yes. Live chat before we go. We're going to go in a minute.
We're going to go in a minute.
It's 5 past midnight. It's after midnight now. Reem Aldor says the old phones are better, actually. Yes, I agree. Well, my phone is very old.
Pedro, yes, Mr. Duncan's lesson will be available.
Yes, it'll be available later, probably tomorrow now. Tomorrow morning or tomorrow afternoon, UK time, because I have to go to bed in a minute because it's very late.
What's Caridas saying? De gustibus non disputandum.
De gustibus non disputandum.
What does that mean?
I think disputandum.
Dispute.
Without dispute. Yes. Something. I don't know what gusto. Maybe it means with passion.
Mm-hmm.
Gustibus. It sounds like gusto. Or maybe
just
to say something with passion or energy. So it doesn't matter what kind of religion we believe. Humanity, love, innovation and charity are more important. Thank you, Lejev or Lej Ali.
We would all get on perfectly all right together if it wasn't for religious leaders. That's who I'm blaming tonight.
OK, not me.
Religious
Steve.
Leaders. They're all to blame. Because they've got their own agendas and they want to set one group of people against another. And it's horrible.
Well, that's good. Thank you. Thank you, Steve.
It is. It's always somebody rises up who thinks that they're...
Oh, Peru is on.
Peru.
Oh, Peru. I don't get many people on the live chat watching in Peru. Jordano. Hello, Jordano. Greetings from Peru. Great video. Yes, you are watching a live stream at the moment. This is live. It's now 7 minutes past midnight.
You couldn't miss your post there because it was in capital letters. So that was a very good idea.
It's not always a good idea, though, to use capital letters. Sometimes it's not good, especially in formal writing.
Ah, but Jordano was noticed because of that. It doesn't matter on the live chat, though, does it?
Anyway, Martin's going.
I bet you've got work tomorrow.
Martin's going. He's got some sense.
You don't want to be tired for work tomorrow. Bye, Martin.
Bye, Martin. Steve's
See
waving.
See you soon for that curry or Chinese.
I like the way Steve was waving then, and we're not on the screen. See you later, Martin. Yes, we'll meet up soon for a drink and maybe a curry or a Chinese. Sounds good to me. Mr. Steve is paying.
No, I'm not.
So we're going in a moment, because I think everyone is falling asleep now, including Steve. So that's it. We've sorted the problem out, and that's what I will do next time. Next time there is a problem, I will just close the encoder and then reopen it straight away, and then the live stream will continue.
I think something worth mentioning there again. Mm-hmm. Pedro said that he wasn't sure about the time changes.
Yes.
So we missed the live, so it might be worth mentioning that. Do you think?
I think that's a very good idea, actually. Yes. So last weekend the clocks went forward 1 hour, so we went from GMT, so that's Greenwich Meridian time or Greenwich Mean time, and we went forward to British Summer time, so we went forward 1 hour. So when you are working out the time difference, you have to work out also that difference as well. So we've gone forward by 1 hour, so we've effectively lost an hour. So depending on where you are in the world depends on whether you add an hour or take it away. I really hate time zones. I just wish everyone on the planet had the same time. It would be much easier.
Yeah, so depending on where you are, you're either going to be watching us an hour later or an hour earlier. So you just have to sort of, depending on whether you're east or west of us, presumably.
Yes.
So, yes, you just have to look up somewhere telling you what the time in the UK is now.
Yes.
Not the time that it was last time you saw Mr. Duncan a week before last.
Well, I've just said you add an hour, so you go forwards by 1 hour.
Yes.
So if you're behind us, it's a different time, and if you're ahead of us, it's also a different time. So of course some people have also changed their time zones as well, so it gets even more confusing. So some countries, especially in Europe, one or two countries also change their clocks. So it just gets so confusing every time this happens. Every year when the clocks go forward and then back again, I always have this same problem. People miss the live streams because they think we haven't arrived yet, or maybe they just miss the live stream because they think we're not on yet. So it just does your head in. It does your head in. So there you go.
So we're off then. So yes,
we are off. Mr. Steve is going to wash his face and is going to brush his teeth. He's going to comb his hair 100 times, just like his mum told him to.
Yeah, that's why it all fell out.
That's why it all fell out. So we'll see you later. Apparently it's the same in Italy, plus 1 hour last week. Yes, that's right. It, you see. Thank you very much to your Dano, Ultimus, Pedro, and everyone else who has been on the live chat. It's lovely. Clebson, Mario, Khalid, Reem, also Martin, our friend.
He's gone to bed.
Yes, he's gone now.
Somebody just said, can you post the lesson immediately? We can't.
Unfortunately, we have to wait for YouTube to process it. So it takes about 2 hours to process. And then, of course, I will be asleep by then. So I'm going to bed right now because it's nearly 12:15. So it is now Thursday morning. Morn day Thursday.
That's it.
As Steve told us earlier.
I'll be washing your feet later.
I think Steve has become a bit religious, you know.
Maybe. Is there a halo over my head?
No, there isn't. Well, it depends which way you're going, really. You know, because there are two ways you can go.
There's a halo.
I don't think there's a halo. I think there's a tail and some horns coming out of his head.
I don't like the sound of that.
No, me neither.
So, yes, this lesson will go on, but not till tomorrow morning.
So I hope that's clear, and we are going now. Thank you from Morocco, Khalid. Yes. And also Amina. Thank you very much. Amina has just arrived.
Oh,
that's a shame because we're going now.
Oh, yes. Sorry. We're going now.
We've been on for 2 hours.
I've been on for an hour with you.
So that's it. We're going. Hours, there is yes, no more.
I've got work tomorrow.
We will see you on Sunday, 2 o'clock UK time, 2 p.m. UK time. Don't forget to work out the difference if you are watching or if you want to catch us at a certain time, because there is a time difference now. We've gone forward 1 hour. And that's it. We'll see you later, Mr. Steve.
Okay, then. I'll let you wrap up.
I will wrap
up. And see you on Easter Sunday with chocolate all round our mouths.
Yeah.
Bye.
Catch you later. There goes Mr. Steve. And I'm going as well in a moment. Thanks for joining me. I'm very sorry about the problem with the internet earlier. My encoder broke. So I closed it and started it again, and then I returned. So we will see you on Sunday, 2 p.m. UK time. This is Mr. Duncan in the birthplace of English, saying thank you so much for watching, and I will see you on Sunday. Thank you, Louise. Thank you, Mutomi. And thank you very much for watching. It has been very interesting, despite some of the problems. See you later. This is Mr. Duncan for the last time saying, well, you know what I'm about to say. Ta-ta for now.